beautiful weather has snowbirds flocking to South Florida this time of year. Some come by air, while others take to the sea.
Hi, I am Joe Gallegos. I'm the captain on the motor yacht Gitana, 158-foot Fedship. Gitana is a 1997 Fedship. She was designed by a car designer, which was very different for Fedship. She has traveled the world and just continues to go, go, go.
We climb aboard this beautiful vessel and find out what it takes to design a superyacht on today's SoFlo Home Project. Welcome to SoFlo Home Project. I'm Alena Capra. On our show, we usually talk design and South Florida lifestyle on land. But today, we've got a special treat for you. We'll be taking you out to sea, SoFlo style. This 158-foot superyacht was built in 1997. It has four decks and five staterooms that accommodate 12 guests and sails with a crew of 10. Hi, Joe. Welcome to SoFlo Home Project.
Welcome, Alena.
So we're here today with Joe Gallegos, who is the captain of the Gitana. Joe, this is going to be a great tour because we don't always get to tour super yachts.
We will entertain you the best we can.
So when you come aboard here, it's just such a relaxing vibe and, of course, very expansive at that as well.
Gitana is a 1997 Fedship. Fedship is considered the icon of yachting.
And then talking about some of the maintenance, because this runs completely differently than a home. Obviously, a lot of the furnishings here aren't so easy to pick up and move.
Everything on a yacht is designed to stay in place where we can. There are certain things like the dining room chairs, the main salon chairs.
The stuff that needs to move.
When we go to sea, we have to secure everything.
So as you see it now, is only when you are docked and everything is just kind of anchored.
Or light cruising. When they do a yacht interior, everything is meant to be useful, functional, and believe it or not to hurt you. There's so many things involved.
Safety is a huge factor.
You have a stewardess that bangs into a corner. You have an injury. So you have to watch corners. You have to watch everything when a yacht interior is being done.
So we talk about safety, but also the things that might be bolted down so they don't move.
Anything that doesn't move is all the light fixtures, any table ornaments, all that's loose.
So this lamp,
everything is fixed to the table. The table's bolted to the floor. It's designed where we don't have to worry about it when we travel.
Okay, so that's all in place. And then, of course, all the accessories, things like that, those get moved away and set back out.
Yes, there's pre-planning on everything we do. We have to be able to move this boat on an hour or two notice.
So you've got this down pat.
Yeah, no, it's and it has to be done right.
So everything that's in here, pretty much from the paneling to what's going on with the ceiling, those all are removable panels. How does this work in terms of the upholstered panels I'm seeing?
A good boat, you have about 60% of the interior we could remove and get at the plumbing, the wiring, anything we need to fix.
So these are access panels?
Everything is an access panel where it can be an access panel. There are certain areas where you cannot get stuff through that the shipyard will put tubes through to drop future wires or if they're good.
So when it comes to designing the interiors of a yacht, there is so much that has to be kind of coordinated. It's not just the design team.
I've done multiple new builds. I've done half a dozen or more major refits, and you have designers, you have naval architects, you have flag state, you have Lloyd's Registry. When you do a refit, the captain's kind of it to make sure everything works, and there is a lot of moving parts that you have to make sure of.
So a lot of moving parts, and of course a lot of parts that don't move because they're bolted down. So I feel like this is a great kind of intro here in the Grand Salon. I'm excited to continue touring through the Gitana with you, learning a little bit more about some of the other areas of here, other great entertaining spaces, and we're going to do that when we come back. Coming up, we navigate further into the main deck where we find the owner's stateroom on SoFlo Home Project.
Hey, Mike Martinez from USA Windows and Doors here. Today we've got something special for you. We're going to be talking about garage doors, how beautiful they can be, and how they add value to your home.
We What could you do in your home with a $500 Goya Seasonings Greetings gift card? Well, if that sounds good to you, go to local10.com to register. The Goya Seasonings Greetings winner will be chosen on January 3rd, 2023. Go to local10.com for your chance to win Goya Seasonings Greetings $500 gift card giveaway. Because if it's Goya, it has to be good. Welcome back to SoFlo Home Project. I'm Alena Capra, and we are continuing to tour this beautiful super yacht, the Gaitana, with Captain Joe Gallegos. Joe, so this has been a lot of fun so far, just kind of learning a little bit more about the Gaitana itself. So now we're in, what would we consider this area? The owner's stateroom?
Master stateroom, owner's stateroom. It's kind of the owner's apartment on most yachts.
The owner's stateroom is located towards the bow of the main deck. It's a grand space where we find all the comforts of home. So this is going to be the biggest sleeping quarters in the entire space. And here we have a beautiful seated area. You talked about having sort of an office area as well. Again, everything
bolted down.
The only things that are moving are the functional pieces of furniture. And same thing here with a lot of the paneling. All of this is the accessible paneling.
All pop-down, removable, electrical, plumbing. When they build the boats, everything has to be acceptable. 90% of what we deal with on a yacht, you don't even see it.
Wow, so it's all kind of behind the scenes, behind the panels. So I see there's a lot of hardware. Are these drawers over here?
Everything opens, but everything secures. So when you lift a standard drawer on a yacht, you lift up and pull out. They all have little notches to keep them from sliding.
They don't slide out with movement. Yep. It looks like space is always a premium. So here, the way everything is just kind of almost hidden, but you have functional storage.
A proper yacht has every void accessible and stored.
And you have drawers, you have storage, I'm assuming maybe a TV behind here?
TV and stereo systems are always hidden on yachts. Everything is designed to be clean and functional and only use it and open it when you want it.
Carpeting really is.
Carpeting is still the safest sound reduction there is. You never want an environment where if we had a wood floor in this master stateroom, I would be terrified of the crew quarters noise transmitting up through it.
Understood.
When this boat's running, you could feel zero vibration on this floor.
Wow.
We use a sound pad underneath the carpet, but then there's actually probably 3 inches of sound systems built into the plywoods.
That is a cool fact to know. Now, this is a beautiful stateroom, but this is not the whole kind of part of it. There's a beautiful bathroom, which is referred to often as the head.
The master stateroom head.
Okay, so we have that on the other side of here, and we are gonna share a beautiful space with you. But before we do that, let's check in with Mike Martinez from USA Windows and Doors and see what advice he has for us today.
Hey, Mike Martinez here from USA Windows and Doors. We're at one of our showrooms, one of our partner companies at Your Service Garage Doors. We're gonna talk about garage doors in total and how it can help your house, not just with functionality and protection, but beautify your home tremendously. Coming inside, let's take a look. So we're inside now and we got all the windows and the doors, things that you'd expect USA Windows and Doors to carry, but I've got a special surprise for you. USA Windows and Doors carries a complete line of garage doors. The largest door facing the street, it's what makes your house unique and special. You can match the front door, you can do different wood tones, you can do blacks, you can do whites, you can do panels, you can do flats. Variety is the key when it comes to garage doors. And each and every one at USA Windows and Doors is Hurricane Garage Door rated. It's gonna be able to withstand all those pressures, give you all the benefits of the insurance breaks that you need to have, and beautify your home tremendously. There are different ways of making it a hurricane door. So most of the time, it's a bracket. And in most garage doors, there's brackets that come across the back, and that's what's holding that wind. It's giving added support from the movement of wind and the impact that's gonna happen. But some garage door companies that we deal with, they're really smart. This particular garage door supplier already has the supports built in. We don't need to have those big ugly brackets out the back. It's a nice little feature to have, and especially if you're gonna do something inside your house where you need those extra 5 or 6 inches of room. And for those who wanna convert their garages, whatever they wanna do inside of it, a theater, a home gym, anything that they wanna do, but they wanna insulate it, they wanna keep that air conditioning from blowing out and losing all that extra electricity, well, now you gotta have an insulated garage door. We can do that as well at USA Windows and Doors. So if you're ready to make that decision and beautify your home that much more, make sure you call the number on the screen. Or better yet, check us out, usawindowsanddoors.com. Remember, we offer the solutions that make sense. Back to you, Alena.
Thanks, Mike. So, Joe, I want to talk about amenities. This space is so beautiful. When I walk in, the first thing I see is this freestanding tub and the skylight. What else is in here?
Every master bathroom has to be functional. There's a shower on the starboard side, there's the head on the port side, separated behind the tub, and then the two vanities. Everywhere you look on a yacht is designed by square inch, and you have to know how to use every square inch to make it feel big, even though it's much smaller.
All about that maximizing of space.
Yep.
But you also want it to look beautiful as well.
You have to be careful. You'll see a lot of boats that have a lot of decorative things around. What happens in, you have a sea, I mean, may not be a big sea, and the owner reaches for a towel bar instead of a handrail and pulls it off the wall. That's
so
the type
grab
of,
bars need
you
to
have
be
to make sure everything
placed.
Is properly placed and utilized for convenience as well as function.
It feels very expansive in this space, and typically I feel like when you're, you know, in a yacht, no matter what the size, the bathrooms don't always feel as large. This, with this two level, the split level, feels quite large.
The hull shapes are V, so the minute you go lower, you get less space. So by raising this one, we've actually utilized the whole hull area and got a lot more function out of it instead of having a wasted area.
And I love the way there's the skylight above. I feel like the inclusion of natural light in a space always makes it feel even bigger than it is.
But you have to be careful with natural lighting on boats too, because there's so many environments you go from room to room that if you have LED lighting, it's too harsh. If you have halogen lighting, it's too hot. You put a natural light, you have a lot of UV exposure. You want to limit any areas where the suns are going to get to the interiors, because it will destroy them in no time. So this type of skylight is not something you would see on a lot of boats.
Okay.
They would avoid skylight situations for one, for leaks, two, for UV exposure, and three, for the maintenance issues involved.
So big decision to put this in.
It was very heavily debated when it went in. In this case, it was actually done right, because there's very limited areas of UV damage.
Well, it looks great, and I love the way it highlights the mural and everything else that's going on here. And in terms of the walls, so you think about bathrooms, we're typically thinking tile. When we are in a yacht, thinner porcelain slab, I know, is a great product now that I'm sure is being used. And here, how much marble to sort of regular other types of wall cladding that's not as heavy?
There's a lot of issues with bathrooms and boats. So a lot of the boats, you will not see this kind of heavy marble use or weight, because they have to get away from it.
So there's a lot of balance.
There's a lot of balance that has to look at it. So the walls are typically not done in heavy material. They will be done in a material that's water resistant, fingerprint resistant. It's every cabin's nightmare to have glossy rooms, because you cannot hide the fingerprints.
So matte finish is best.
Matte finish in utilitarian areas like bathrooms are way easier to maintain. For the owners.
We heard it from you, and that is great advice for even in residential baths, because it shows a lot less water spots and things. So I love that tip as well. Now we are going to continue touring through. We've got more to see, and we're going to bring you all with us when we come back. Coming up next, we go up one deck to explore one of this yacht's great entertaining spaces on SoFlo Home Project. South Florida is beautiful, but there is nothing like the city of Coral Gables. Today we take a look at a new development that revives George Merrick's design legacy and vision for the city. So we are here today joined by Maya de la Vega, who is the founder and CEO of One Sotheby's International Realty. Maya, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
So it's great to have you here today. We want to talk about the Village of Coral Gables and how it's such an amazing project and partnership between MG Developer and One Sotheby's International Realty.
We're very excited to partner with MG Developers, and I think one of the reasons that we're so excited is because the vision that Alirio has created for this project is really very unique. Everything he does is done with tremendous amount of love, and just the finished product is absolutely stunning. He's done it at every single development. So for us, being a luxury brand and aligning ourselves with a company like MG Developers is extremely important, because we know that whatever product we're selling, we know we're going to be able to stand behind it.
So of course we talk about Coral Gables as the city beautiful. I mean, the architecture, and not just only that it is beautiful, but the proximity to so many great shops, restaurants. It's a walkable city in this particular area. So, you know, it's not a high rise. It's village living in luxury, different types of luxury homes. We have the lofts, we have the townhomes, we have the flats. There's so many different styles of living that fit within this luxury village itself.
Absolutely, and that's what I love about the project. It's not your standard high rise. Everything is really taken care of for you, whether it's the flats or the villas or the lofts or the townhomes. I just don't see another project like this in Coral Gables. It's going to be a complete luxury lifestyle, and I see that it's just going to continue to evolve.
Maisa, thank you so much for spending some time with us today and sharing more about the village at Coral Gables.
We can't wait until they break ground, hopefully in the next couple of months. It's going to be the most beautiful project in the city beautiful.
Welcome back to SoFlo Home Project. I'm Alena Capra. And we are continuing to tour the Gitana here with the Captain Joe. So Joe, we saw a lot of other areas sort of that were undercover, but now we are on what seems like a sky lounge?
Sky lounge, bridge deck aft, the main living area on the boat.
On the aft upper deck, we find more entertaining areas. This is a great spot to enjoy outdoor meals and drinks at sea. Great place to be. I mean, very spacious, lots of great seating, and having the undercover dining is probably one of the main things you always need to have.
This dining area is utilized probably 90% of the time on most yachts.
So now, this is the main outdoor entertaining area, but then right behind me over here, through here, now there's a little...
The sky lounge. This whole area is the primary area for people to hang out. Movies, dinner, after dinner, this is kind of the main deck area. Most of the time they're going to be one on this deck level up, because if you were anywhere in the harbor or near anything, you're out of everyone's eyesight up here.
And of course, just a great lounge space, very expansive, and the interior just as much.
Yes, so it becomes one area when the doors are open.
And in there we have large seating area, you said television, things like that.
Salon. It's basically a mini salon, main salon.
And I think very important always to have those multi-levels.
There's a segregation that happens in yachting. Even when you have family members on board, there's usually a level of the daughters or son will take the lower area, the owners will take the upper area. You're not feeling like you're on top of each other all the time. And it's one great thing about yachting is you have the ability to have your private areas and yet you're still together.
Joe, so I know that there is one more level up and I want to check that out and share it with everyone back at home. So can we go ahead and do that?
After you.
All right, when we come back, we're bringing you through. SoFlo Home Project. I'm Alena Capra, and we are continuing to tour the Gitana with the Captain Joe. Joe, so we've seen a lot of great areas of this yacht, but right now we are on a sun deck, and I actually want to call it the fun deck because this is where it's at. On the top level of this yacht, we find the sun deck. This is the perfect spot to relax and enjoy the beautiful views. We've got the hot tub, we've got lounge space. What else is up here?
We carry a tender on the aft deck, and we typically would have water sports equipment aft. The lounge areas, the gym, barbecue.
It's all up here.
Kind of where you, at the end of every day, almost everybody is up here.
It is the fun deck.
Yes.
And I love that there is also, like, first of all, great place to get sun. You could hang out here, but you could also get shade. So it's like that perfect balance of enjoying the outdoors.
Yep. No, when we're running, this is where the owners will typically spend most of the afternoon watching the world go by. And, you know, it could be the south of France. It could be Croatia. It could be Norway. I mean, it's just
anywhere in the world.
Anywhere you want to go.
Well, I'm enjoying this here now, and I just feel like it's a perfect space plan. We talked about before that no matter how large the yacht actually is.
It is. I mean, having this size space on this size boat works out really well.
So this has been such a pleasure. Just, I mean, we didn't tour every single area, but we got the main entertaining spaces and really just got to see so many beautiful parts of the Gitana. So I want to thank you for taking us through and sharing some of the information that we don't get to talk about every week on SoFlo Home Project. We love sort of taking it to sea and getting to know a little bit more about yachts and the design and the maintenance and everything that goes into that.
My pleasure.
And now let's take a look at what design inspiration we have planned for you next week on SoFlo Home Project. We get you into the holiday spirit as we tour the historic Bonnet House Museum and Gardens, which has been decked in beautiful, artistic Christmas decor. So I hope that you all enjoyed this episode of A Little SoFlo at Sea. And we hope to see you again next week for another all-new episode of SoFlo Home Project right here on Local 10. And remember, there's no place like SoFlo Home. If you missed any part of this episode, or if you're looking for more design inspiration, make sure to check out all episodes online at SoFloShows.com. And don't forget to follow us on social media on Facebook and Instagram.